In this video, I'll talk about where to find data analyst jobs exactly. I'll talk about the best websites, of course including the basics like LinkedIn and Indeed, but also a ton of other websites where you can both find on-site jobs, but also remote and work from home jobs, because a lot of you guys have requested that. I'm also going to show you some tricks on these platforms that you can use to find better jobs, find jobs with lower competition, and in general become a data analyst or whatever you're looking for, faster and way easier. We're going to go on this journey together, let's get started. When you're looking for a data analyst job, or any job for that matter, LinkedIn may be your first choice. Unlike many other websites, LinkedIn isn't actually an employment website. And the truth is that most people misunderstand LinkedIn completely. The real power of LinkedIn isn't for job searching. With LinkedIn, you can actually set up your profile, add your projects, education, certifications, and whatever other things you want. And then people can just find you. Recruiters go on LinkedIn all the time, so if you optimize your profile, you put data analyst in the description, looking for work, etc., then people can actually find you. I know a lot of people that got their job just by existing on LinkedIn. They didn't go looking for a job, a recruiter or someone reached out to them, often because they had a common friend. And that is actually the secret. If you build a network on LinkedIn, you will appear in more places to more people. And if you start networking with data analysts, then chances are that someone in your network will be hiring a data analyst. When you add a contact, you'll often get access to all of their contacts as well, and they will also get access to you, which kind of builds a network effect. Think of it like a tree. You're just adding more branches to your tree. So don't be afraid of using LinkedIn like a social media. That's kind of what it is about, and it's the true power of LinkedIn. This is also going to make you look slightly more trustworthy if you have a few contacts in the field. Just don't be that guy that randomly adds everyone and has thousands of contacts just because he thinks it looks cool. It really doesn't. And the secret is, you don't actually need that many contacts, just the right ones. And let me know if you want a dedicated video just on this topic. Next, we're going to talk about Indeed. And it is indeed a platform I recommend. Okay, sorry guys. The thing about Indeed is that they have a lot of nice features that people don't necessarily use. For example, if I go here on data analyst jobs, I can actually click encourage to apply. And then I can find jobs where they specifically encourage people without a degree to apply. You can also click on job type. So if you want to look for a part-time job or something, that might be helpful. Now, it could be a little bit difficult getting a part-time job as a beginner, just to clarify, but you can still use the feature, and I think it's a great plus. They also have experience levels, so if you're an entry-level data analyst, you can just put that, and they also have an education filter, so you can select your own education level and see what companies match with you. Using these filters on Indeed is a great idea, or on any platform for that matter, to save time when applying for jobs. I know that it can be really frustrating checking through a job description and then seeing that you don't actually meet the requirements. Sometimes it can still be worth applying anyway, but I think just using filters properly can save you a lot of hassle. I do want to warn you though, because if you only use the filters, you will miss some jobs. Not every job listing will accurately have these filters, so I highly recommend you to also spend some time without any filters, and you may find some hidden gems that you would have otherwise missed because you simply used the filter. Next up, we have Glassdoor. And for Glassdoor, I kind of have a love and hate relationship with this website. I think a lot of people mostly use it to compare their salaries, which is one of the key benefits of this website. They basically have people fill out their salaries, so they have a lot of data about different industries, companies, and jobs. So if you use their salary estimates, they should be pretty good. When it comes to the amount of jobs on Glassdoor, you're not really gonna find as many as on LinkedIn or Indeed or these huge employment websites, but you can still find some really good job listings. A tip when looking for jobs here, but also on any website, is to try to see when they were posted. If you find a job that's like 30 days old, sure, it could be because they haven't found a candidate yet, but it could also be because they simply haven't removed the job listing. This company might have already hired someone, or they're currently conducting interviews. Companies are unfortunately run by humans, and people forget things. And if you spend all of your time applying for those jobs, you will waste it. Some are going to be like 24 hours or a few days, which I think is much better. By focusing on the opportunities that actually exist, you can save a lot of time. If you're looking to become a data analyst freelancer, then Upwork is a great place to start. If you're experienced and you're looking for the best conditions and high salaries, I think there are better places, but as a beginner, Upwork can be a pretty good place to get started. I've actually worked a bit on Upwork myself a few years ago, and I had a great experience. To be honest, it did take a long time to find a freelance job there. Then I was lucky and I did many contracts for that same company. So I basically worked part-time for them for a couple of months in my own spare time. This was a great thing for me, both for the money, but also to be able to get some experience. All you do is sign up, create a profile, and then you can start looking for jobs. If you set up a nice profile, companies can also reach out to you. Now, I think this is more likely to happen once you have a little bit of experience, but you can still give it a try. It's a good first step, showing that you're at least available for jobs. Now, let's get into the remote work stuff. I know a lot of you guys want to work remotely, want to work from home, so I'm going to show you some websites I recommend. The first one is remote.co, and guess what kind of jobs they exclusively post. This is a very popular website for remote jobs, perhaps the biggest one out there. While it looks kind of shady in my opinion, like it's not the most beautiful website, right? It is actually legit, and all of the jobs on this website are 100% remote. Now, I'm not sure if I'll be able to find a lot of data jobs now. It kind of depends on what I search for. Many times the jobs may not exactly be called data analyst, and in general, I think jobs on this website go away pretty fast. It is a really popular website, and they have a ton of people checking all the time. What I recommend you do is bookmark this website and go ahead and check it once in a while and see if there are any good jobs out there. The next one I recommend is called We Work Remotely, and this website looks a lot nicer compared to the other one. Isn't it beautiful? This website is really good, especially because they have a lot of jobs where you can work from anywhere in the world. This is both if you're someone traveling or if you just live in another country. Working remotely like this also opens you up to a ton of other job opportunities because you're not limited to your geographical location. So while the competition may unfortunately be a downside, there is a positive aspect as well. There may be higher competition, but the job market for remote jobs is also much greater than in your city. Companies pay about $300 to post a job on this website for each job listing, which means that they're serious about hiring people, which I think is a good thing, because if you apply for a job and you're just wasting time, as we mentioned, that is a huge risk. Now, this is a big warning before you go looking for a remote job. When you start out in data or in most fields, to be honest, unless you're kind of in the freelancing space, it can be a real challenge getting a fully remote job. And this is just because a lot of people desire to work from home. Since the pandemic, remote jobs have been up by an insane amount because people just didn't want to return to the office. One tip that I have for you is that there are a lot more hybrid jobs than remote jobs usually, which means you work a couple of days from home and a couple of days from the office. For example, you might work Mondays and Tuesdays in the office and then the rest of the week at home. This hybrid option may be worth considering. Both are good options. Here are the websites we covered in this video one by one, but I'll leave all the links in the description as well. And watch this video next. The YouTube algorithm picked it specifically for you, and you know we trust data. Have an amazing week, guys.